Hi, Father Maximus. I have some questions for you. And I need to just relax here so I can think clearly. The last time I talked to you on the phone, you said that the GOC was working on a statement in which they were going to put an end to the practice of giving communion to new calendarists. You said they were going to make this statement and this was going to be stopped. But soon after that, the GOC went into communion with the Synod in resistance. So I have a question. Were you lying to me or were you just misled yourself? So whatever happened to that statement? That's my first question. And another point I want to raise is, remember that you gave me a blessing or permission to get braces orthodontist treatment because of my two impacted teeth? And I explained to you that I could not relocate. I was stuck here. You gave me your permission, and then I explained to you what Bishop Curtis Black did, and you told me it was wrong what he did. You said the reason he gave was false, and you said Bishop Curtis will have to answer to God for what he did to me, but you didn't do anything to defend my right. You even told me to attend church for a year before I go to your monastery. Remember, I was thinking of going to your monastery, and Bishop Sergius's church was the only one I had. He pushed me out illegally, uncanonically, because I was innocent. I had not been excommunicated for any sin, heresy, or schism. And by the way, he pushed three families out too. This man is an antichrist, this Bishop Sergius Black. But you didn't defend my right to go there. Why, Father Maximus? Why? Does that not register in your mind as corrupt? So, and I also want to know, why did you go along with the union with the Synod and resistance? This doesn't make any sense at all. Why didn't you be a man and have some backbone and stand up for your church? See, if it was me, this would not have happened. I mean, I see, if I ever witnessed, if I was in the GOC and I ever witnessed a priest giving communion to a new calendarist, I would have tried to talk him out of it. And then if he wouldn't listen, I would physically prevent this from happening because I would be saving a soul by doing that. Because according to the 2002 encyclical, these people that receive communion in GOC churches receive it to their own condemnation. So it would be virtuous for me to prevent this from happening. I would not have tolerated this whatsoever. And I would not have allowed this union with the Synod resistance. I would have, the clergy that went in agreement or went along with this, the bishops and priests, I would physically throw them out of these churches. If I was in a church and I saw one of these Kyprianite clergymen in a GOC church, I would physically throw them out. These people who were pretending to be GOC Christians, yet they go into communion with the Synod resistance, I would physically throw them out or die trying. Hopefully I'd be arrested and go to jail. That would be great. I'd praise God for going to jail for defending the truth and what I believe to be the truth. But when I look at you clergy, you just seem so soft and so indifferent. You don't have backbone. You don't have manliness. And this is altogether a sign of the times we live in. Men are becoming more effeminate. So that's how I am. I would have thrown these men out. And maybe, you know, if I got killed in the process or arrested, glory be to God, that would be great. But you can't compromise as an Orthodox Christian. And another thing is, remember when I was considering going to your monastery? I was considering going there at a time that I didn't know that your clergy were violating the 2002 encyclical and giving communion to new calendarists. And when I found out about this, I was just kind of sitting back watching what was going to happen, observing things, and hoping they would stop. And there was a time in the early days when I entered the GOC paradigm that I was considering going to your monastery, and I told you how Vladimir Moss had told me that if I ever witnessed anyone at that monastery giving communion to a new calendarist, to leave the monastery. That's how serious this violation is, according to Vladimir Moss. And you said that you disagreed, that you said that the devil would create the scenario in order to get me out of that monastery. So that implies that you believe it's the devil who wanted to get me out of that monastery. Do you still believe that? I'm curious to know if you still believe that. But anyway, if, according to Latimer Moss, this violation is so severe that it demands, it requires a monk who has made monastic vows and has been tonsured to leave a monastery, what does that say about all the laymen? That means that not only should a monk leave a monastery, but the laymen should have left the churches. So basically, these are my observations, my questions to you, I'm sorry, Father Maximus. And I once looked up to you, I once trusted you, and I just look at you now as a complete phony. You were a total fraud, a total fraud. And you once had the audacity to tell me that I need to regain trust in clergy, when look at what you did to me. This hypocrisy, you didn't defend my right to attend Bishop Sergius's church, the church you pointed me to. And you violated my email privacy, which is reprehensible. I trusted you, Father Maximus. I clarified previous confessional sins in my emails to you. It was never made known to me that Bishop Christodoulos had access to your email account, and then one day he accidentally wrote me from your email account. He even admitted it was an accident, that he meant to write me from his own email account. And when I asked you about this, I kindly asked you about this, you never answered. And yet you want me to regain trust in clergy? It's certainly not going to be your clergy. So my email privacy was violated. You didn't apologize or give any kind of explanation. You didn't do anything about Bishop Sergius Black. And you didn't stop the 2002 encyclical violations. You weren't doing enough. And you just went along with the unit in the Senate, with the Senate resistance. And it's like, you people are such frauds. You're such hypocrites. It's astonishing. And the Senate resistance is totally invalid according to the canons of orthodoxy. They're deposed schismatics, but just think of their character as well. I heard Archbishop Chrysostomos of Etna take the name of Jesus Christ in vain 2 times during my visits there many years ago. Father Akakios the abbot swears at monks. And I made a whole video talking about my experiences with them and the experiences other people have had. And these are the people you went into communion with, Father Maximus. So you should be ashamed of yourself. And I forgive you for your actions, but I can't forgive you for betraying the GOC. You'd have to repent of that in order for me to forgive you. So these things can't be tolerated. So those are my questions and observations. I want to add something here. It is crystal clear to me that the GOC realized that I was not going to tolerate their 2002 encyclical violations, and that I would not have tolerated their union with the Senate in resistance. So they just dropped me off like I never existed. People, how Christian is that? How Christian is that? That is totally not Christian. In fact, it's anti-Christian. This is not the way Christ is. These people are not like Christ. Once they realize you're not going to tolerate their disobedience, their hypocrisy, they just drop you off like you never existed. They don't care what happens to you. They don't care if you're scandalized and lose your faith. It's just pure and profound selfishness. These people do not represent Jesus Christ on earth. They do not represent God on earth. They are complete frauds. Thank you for listening.